Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here. In the Philippines, I got a really great preaching video to do that was upon me to do yesterday. The devil tried to jam me up, but praise God, I'll make it later on today. I have another video to make that's very important, brothers and sisters. Out of the blue a few days ago, I mentioned it to Brother Jason when I was getting ready to be on his radio show, but I didn't know the meaning. So, you know, I discussed this with him the other day. The Lord had just began to speak to me out of the blue about this rabbi that's getting ready to die and his vision. And the Lord told me, look, you know, the guy's a Kabbalist, okay? And he did, what he's doing is not from the Spirit of God. So, as an example, what the Lord told me is this. It says, when people try to discern this Messiah by divination or by evil spirit, all hell is about to break loose upon the people of the nation of Israel. So the Lord gave me these texts. So this video needs to go viral. So this may be the only time you hear this. When the wise men went to go see Jesus, people keep talking about, you know, the Magi, and they were magicians. They were wizards. There's this speculation that they were students of Daniel. I've mentioned that myself before a long time ago in videos, but the truth is they were magicians, and they tried to divine that there was a king going to be born in Israel. You know, the devil, you know, knows about Jesus. Now, a lot of people, when you first hear this, you never heard it before, but this is the truth. They divined by a different spirit and by magic and by astrology and all this about the Messiah. All hell broke loose. Herod sent there and killed all the children under 2 years old. Now, I never even thought about this myself, but the Lord's telling me. Okay, and then number two is that the Lord gave me two texts as a witness. The Bible says that everything be established by two more witnesses. The second witness that the Lord gave me is when the girl with the python spirit, which is actually what it really says in the text, but there when Paul was beaten, I can't remember if he's with Silas or who it is. Anyway, they were in the Philippian jail in Philippi. There was a girl that kept following him around, and she was actually possessed by that python spirit is actually the spirit of Apollo, Apollios, Apollyon. These names are all interchangeable in ancient Greek writings. Apollyons, yes, the same Apollyon, Apollo from the who's the beast, the captain of the, you know, the scorpions from the bottomless pit, who is the spirit of the Antichrist. Really, the Antichrist will either be the fallen angel Apollo or possessed by the spirit of Apollyon. Anyhow, and I've done lots of teachings on that way back. Anyway, she was following Paul and them around saying, these men are the servants of the Most High God who will show us the way to salvation. And then finally, Paul cast that spirit out of her. Now, this was the spirit of Antichrist who were following them around and keep yelling that at them for days. And, you know, for all you people that think we just can't go around casting demons out of people for no reason, Paul let her follow them around for a long time. I haven't looked at the text today. I think it's a few days. And then finally, Paul got tired of hearing it and cast the demon out of her, the fallen angel spirit, whatever, that she was channeling. She was a fortune teller for some business people who had her, you know, put in a ceremony and to become possessed by the spirit so they could make money off of her divination. She was a slave who was, you know, purposely possessed so that she could make money for them. So after the demon was cast out, or this spirit of the fallen angel was cast out of her, they were mad because they were going to lose money, and they had Paul and his partner beaten, and I can't remember which one it was, Silas or whatever, and they were put in the Philippian jail, and then there was an earthquake at midnight because they praised the Lord and they got released and all that. But anyway, those are the two witnesses that the Lord gave me. And he said it was in reference to this rabbi. And the Lord told me that, you know, he's a Kabbalist, and he's trying to do this, you know, he tried to do this divination to find out who the Messiah was. So I was just telling Brother Jason about it before we went on the air on the radio show the other night, but I didn't know what it meant. And now the Lord led me. I found an article written on raptureready.com. And I'll put the link down here. It's by a woman, Cynthia Nara. N-U-A-R-A, and she's talking about this rabbi okay, and what he said. So a lot of people run around saying that, and you know, I was already thinking after the Lord told me this, that okay, what he divined is probably going to be the Antichrist, and that after Ariel Sharon dies, you know, all hell's going to break loose on Israel. It's going to be trouble for Israel because, you know, just like those two examples I gave you, trouble for those who were involved in this, you know, divination trying to reveal about the Messiah, about God. Okay. This is some of the things that he said. This is what the rabbi said. Listen to what this Rabbi Keturah said about the Messiah. Okay. It is hard for many, see, because that, I tell you what, the biggest scourge on the internet is P.P. Simmons. He's the one that put this out a long time ago. I saw it about this rabbi two or three years ago. He always leaves out all the details. He also thinks that Obama's Antichrist, we're in the middle of the tribulation, and the guy who was a former missionary in Mexico is now joined up with him, and all of their, you know, P.P. Simmons has got all this politics and stuff involved, but there's a lot of half-truths, if you will follow up on the things he says. So, they're dangerous. According to P.P. Simmons and all of them, we're already in the middle of the tribulation. I mean, they don't even believe in the rapture, and they believe in all this wacky doctrine. It's like the tribulation period is not just a seven-year period. It's over a period of 1,000 years or 2,000 years, and all this wacky doctrine that P.P. Simmons has. So he's the one that put this out there. People have been running with it without reading. You know, that's why the Lord has spoke to me about it. I haven't had time to follow up on it, but then, you know, the Lord just led me now to find this article. So listen to this. This is what that Rabbi Keturah said. It is hard for many people, good people in the society, to understand the person of the Messiah. The leadership and order of the Messiah of flesh and blood is hard to accept for many in the nation. As leader, the Messiah will not hold any office, but will be among the people and use the media to communicate. This is going to be the Antichrist. Listen to this. His reign will be pure and without personal or political desire. During his dominion, only righteousness and truth will reign. Will all believe in the Messiah right away? No. In the beginning, some of us will believe in him and some not. When Jesus comes back to earth to rule and reign, there's no time period of believing or not believing. It will be easier for non-religious people to follow the Messiah than for Orthodox people. The revelation of the Messiah will be fulfilled in two stages. First, he will actively confirm his position as Messiah without knowing himself that he is the Messiah. Does Jesus know that he's the Messiah? Yes. Then he will reveal himself to some Jews, not necessarily to wise Torah scholars, and it can even be simple people. Only then will he reveal himself to the whole nation. The people will wonder and say, was that the Messiah? Many will know his name, but have not believed that he is the Messiah. He also said when he comes, the Messiah will rescue Jerusalem from foreign nations that want to rule the city. They will not succeed, for they will fight against one another. And he said, let's see what else he says. With the help of God, the soul of the Messiah has attached itself to a person in Israel. See, I already read before he said that, way back when I first read this, 3 or 4 years ago. I've forgotten this. This Rabbi Keturah says, with the help of God, the soul of the Messiah has attached itself to a person in Israel. What? That's worth a what. You know, it's sad someone's trying to patent that word, what? Because it's a common word, and this is a place for a what? Let's see. I'm trying to see that, you know, what more things he said. So anyway, this whole thing about him being a soul attached himself to people, there's more and more. I'll put the link down here. But anyway, you know, the Lord had already warned me about this the other day, and I hadn't made a video about it because I didn't know exactly what the Lord was trying to tell me. And I thought the Lord was alluding to that, not necessarily that he didn't name the Messiah. It's just that all hell's going to break loose. And I was just waiting on the Lord for confirmation. So, A, I believe that he's divining, he divined through Kabbalism, which is, you know, this tree of knowledge, really. The Kabbalist symbol is really, they call it the tree of life. It's really the tree of knowledge. All this New Age junk is all mixed in there. As a matter of fact, you're talking about those who say they're Jews and are not. You look at the Rothschilds and all those guys, they're into all this stuff. Madonna and other people, they're into this Kabbalism. Kabbalism, as a matter of fact, could be, you know, a great example of what could become the world religion. It's mysticism, New Age, and all this stuff. It is definitely not the spirit of Christ, but the spirit of Antichrist. It is evil, and it is not biblical Judaism. You know, those Orthodox rabbis or ultra-Orthodox rabbis who try to follow, you know, the Tanakh only. There's a group of them. I can't remember the name of all these groups, but There's only one little sect of Judaism that's actually Tanakh only followers, Tanakh being the Old Testament. There's only a small group of them who actually follow that only with no extra biblical writings. Most of those groups are actually, most of your Jewish groups are actually followers of different rabbis, you know, who said something and they're like following that, their interpretation of the Old Testament, not going just straight to the Old Testament. There's only a small group that do. You know, those are the ones who won't be fooled. Those are the ones who will know that, hey, the Antichrist is not the Christ, because they're studying the Bible only, you know, and being the Holy Spirit can speak to them through that. And they could not be, you know, keep from being deceived by the Antichrist. Anyway, brothers and sisters, let this be a warning to you from the Lord. It's in my spirit. When Ariel Sharon dies and all these people are looking, A, of course, the Antichrist is going to be, will appear. And number two, look for the war of Gog and Magog or some stuff like that, that all hell will break loose there in Israel. And that's what's been in my spirit from the Lord. I've got another video to make. It's called an indictment. The Lord gave me the title, and I already had the message in my spirit yesterday. We were waiting on our landlord to show up, and you know, they're the ones that's doing all this demonic divination, and then they didn't come and didn't come and didn't come and didn't come. I didn't want to start the video and have it interrupted. It's little ways like that that the devil will try to hinder us. This is a lesson to you guys, you know. That's how he operates, even in the small things. If he can't get you with the big stuff, he'll try to get you with the small stuff. But anyway, brothers and sisters, the title of the message, the Lord gave me the title, and this is it. An indictment of the Laodicean church. An indictment of the Laodicean church. I'll be making it later on as the Spirit of the Lord would come upon me to make it again. I'm just waiting on the Lord. I already have the message in my heart, but it's not quickened. You know, when you hear all this preaching of people that prepare their sermons a year in advance, the church I went to, you know, they have a schedule of what the preacher's going to preach for the whole year. It's not quickened. It might be the Word of God, but it's not anointed. And so, by the grace of God, I don't want to make a video unless it's anointed and quickened by the Holy Spirit. So God bless you guys. I'll get this loaded, and then I'm in prayer, waiting on the Lord to move on me to make the video, an indictment of the Laodicean church. It's going to be a great video by the grace of God, a message that needs to go viral. Unfortunately, most people will be more interested in this video because I said that this rabbi is really revealing the Antichrist, number two, that all hell's going to break loose in Israel and all that kind of stuff, which is things that we know is going to happen. It's already in the Bible. And we as Christians shouldn't be looking to those things. But those people who want to know by divination, they don't want to hear from the Lord themselves, but someone else, they're so interested. God bless you guys. Those of you who love the meat of the Word, God bless you. And may the Lord give you the desires of your heart.